What's up, guys? Today we're doing vocal chops like the one in this video. So, guys, you need want to get a cappella. I've got a Selena Gomez one here from the Wolves. Just go on YouTube, search a cappella, YouTube converter, and bring in it, and then Control E. And then I'll turn it into MIDI regions. And you need this. Unless you want to sit chopping it up manually. So here's all the regions. And then now, if you don't like how the regions have been done already, you go there and then you say slicing, and then you can choose where it slices. Normally it does a pretty good job, but if it like cuts off a vowel or something, you might want to change it. So you can do that manually like that. And then the same thing, you go Control E, and then same thing would happen. You get a MIDI region, and then you can start playing around with it. So then here, let's listen to it. Oh, here's the notes, the MIDI are made. What happens is the acapella doesn't always have all the notes you want to use. So then what you do is you go here to the EX settings, and then you go pitch, and you can go coarse tune, and see how I've drawn in my own little. So now that's all edited. I now made that sound like that, because without it, yeah, switch it off, it sounds like this. And now that is the sounds that the original gave me, but because, see, and I didn't like the way the original was, so I chose to edit it further. And here, now, what we're doing is we're making tonal snares. So you go to your EQ, and you make the peaks, and then you... So yeah, there, you see the peaks, so now you want to elevate them so that it creates, like, even more harmonics or more emphasis on that sound. So here, I'll show you with it. And we actually need more. I just want a subtle effect of it sticking out a bit more. I don't want too much, so. Here's without it. And then with it. And if you, see, if you want that to stand out in the mix, then you need to do this. And it's also cool because you can scope for different frequencies, and it'll give it a different kind of tone. So now these are the chords. You want to use seventh chords. This is just an extra. So Logic shows you the chords if you highlight it, or if you play it. See, as I see, it'll tell you what chord you're playing, which is quite cool. Really, you can like learn theory just from playing around on this keyboard and looking at the notes. Here's the final playthrough. I hope you guys enjoyed the video.